여러분, 설립자이신 한학자 종재와 선학평화상위원회 홍일식 위원장께서 입장하고 계십니다.
Now the founder of the Sonak Peace Prize, Dr. Hakja Han Moon, and Sonak Peace Prize Committee Chairman, Dr. Il-Shik Hong, will make their entrance. Ladies and gentlemen, please give them a big round of applause.
여러분 다시 한번 힘찬 박수로 환영해 주십시오. 한학자 총재께서는 오늘 제1회 시상식을 맞이하는 선학평화상의 설립자로 부군이신 고 문선명 총재와 함께 세계를 무대로 평화와 참사랑의 이상을 이루기 위해 헌신적 삶을 살아왔습니다.
Dr. Hakja Han Moon, who founded the Sonak Peace Prize, which is being held for the first time ever today, has devoted herself together with her husband, the late Reverend Dr. Son Myung Moon. So ladies and gentlemen, please once again give a big round of applause.
여러분 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다. 이제 오늘 행사의 주인공을 만나보실 순서입니다. 여러분 큰 박수로 오늘의 주인공을 맞아보겠습니다. 아노테통 대통령께서는 남태평양의 아름다운 섬나라 키리바시 공화국의 현직 대통령이십니다. 키리바시는 지구 온난화의 영향으로 2050년에 수몰 위기에 처해 있는데요. 통 대통령은 국제사회의 기후 평화를 외치고 있는 글로벌 리더입니다.
His Excellency Anote Tong is the incumbent president of the Republic of Kiribati, a beautiful island country in the South Pacific. Kiribati is threatened by the possibility of submergence into the sea by 2050 due to climate change. President Tong is a global leader urging climate peace in the international community and is taking leadership to establish the world's largest marine environmental protection area.
네, 그리고 모다두구 굽타 박사께서는 인도의 수산 과학자십니다. 양식 어종을 개량해 생산량을 획기적으로 늘리면서 청색 혁명을 일궈낸 분입니다. 생명을 무릅쓰고 평생을 가난한 이웃들과 함께 헌신적인 삶을 살아오신 빈민의 성자십니다.
Dr. Modadugu Vijay Gupta is an Indian fisheries scientist who has remarkably increased fish production by improving fish aquaculture technologies. He has achieved the blue revolution. Fish farming is regarded today as a possible solution to the future food crisis. And Dr. Gupta is the saint to the poor, devoting his entire career living together with the poor while ignoring threats to his own life.
네, 그럼 지금부터 주인공들을 모시고 미래 세대를 위한 제1회 선학평화상 시상식을 시작하겠습니다.
Now we will officially begin the inaugural 2015 Sonak Peace Prize ceremony, making the world better for future generations.
네, 여러분의 박수로 시작해 보겠습니다. 저는 오늘 영광스러운 자리에 진행을 맡은 신영일 아나운서입니다.
저는 국제 아나운서 정세입니다. On my right is broadcaster Young In Shin, and I am Sammy Jung, Arirang TV announcer.
네, 반갑습니다. 자, 그럼 먼저 오늘 이 자리가 이기까지의 과정을 영상에 담아봤습니다. 화면을 통해서 확인하시겠습니다.
First, through a video presentation, we would like to introduce the process that lead us to this ceremony.
The future course of history will be shaped by those living at this time. In the 20th century, world wars among nation states threatened humanity's survival. In the 21st century, we face new challenges, even in the midst of globalization, economic development, and advances in technology. For in the shadow of such growth and development, the Earth itself is being threatened by exploitation and abuse. The planet that sustains our lives is at risk, and along with it, all of us. If we are to overcome this challenge, we must change. Global warming, food crisis, energy depletion. The human heart longs for peace, and yet violence, conflict, and destruction seem to grow stronger. Humanity is crying out in earnest, calling for a new era, a new civilization of peace. The future of our planet Earth hangs in the balance. May there be harmonious coexistence between humankind and the Earth. The time has come for us to open the way to a new era of peace, a civilization of peace, and a world in which all people live together in harmony, living for the sake of one another and for the sake of future generations. The Sunhok Peace Prize hears the cries of future generations who long for peace. The Sunhok Peace Prize is dedicated to building a civilization of peace for future generations. Peace was given to us by God, but we have lost it somewhere, and now we spend our lives looking for it in all the wrong places. A vision of peace includes the whole human family and should be established in every corner of the world, north, south, east, and west. Reverend Sun Myung Moon and his wife, Dr. Hakja Han Moon, comforted mothers in Africa who were without the resources to feed their starving children. They worked to help fathers in South America who could not provide enough nutrition for their children. And so they took action, building schools and developing the fishing industries to benefit the families and children. And they watched as hope blossomed on the faces of the children. They poured their heart and soul into resolving conflicts. They met with President Mikhail Gorbachev of the Soviet Union as part of their efforts to bring about the reconciliation of communism and democracy. They also met with President Kim Il-sung of North Korea to propose a path to peace on the Korean Peninsula. They invested their time and resources in the United States to lead a spiritual and moral awakening. And they also led a movement to promote dialogue and cooperation among Jews, Christians, and Muslims, and people of all faiths. If we are to bring an end to suffering and conflict, we must practice love for one another. This is the way of peace. This is the way to break down the barriers that divide us as people. We are one human family. We are one family under God. The human family develops over time from generation to generation. We must think about the kind of world we want to pass on to our children. In August of 2014, the Sunhok Peace Prize took its very first step by launching its selection committee. Made up of prominent figures from various nationalities, religious backgrounds, and professional fields.
전 세계적으로 노벨 평화상을 능가하는 선학 평화상을 제정해 나갈 것입니다. 이 역사는 어느 한 개인의 명예나 단체의 명예보다는 보다 더 하늘의 뜻과 인류의 평화를 위해서 크게 공헌한 사람 또 단체로서 역사적인 자리에 서게 될 것입니다.
The vision of the Sunhok Peace Prize is being welcomed around the world. While the prize was being instituted, the East Timor government recognized its importance and offered a substantial donation.
선학평화상위원회는 매회 시상에서 인류 공동의 운명을 평화적인 방법으로 이끌 미래 평화 아젠다를 제시하고자 합니다. 제1회 시상에서 본위원회가 제시하는 미래 평화 아젠다는 기후변화와 식량 위기입니다.
Respecting human rights, resolving conflict, and promoting sustainable development for the sake of the future. These are the objectives of the Sunhok Peace Prize. In the blue sea, we observe peace and harmony in the waves. Healthy oceans are essential to establishing a world of peace. The sea, which is the source of all life, is the regulator of the Earth's environment that maintains all life. Hope lies in the oceans. Reverend Sun Myung Moon and his wife, Dr. Hakja Han Moon, with the insight that the future depends on the seas, have consistently promoted their vision for healthy oceans and a global civilization of peace. The 2015 first Sunhok Peace Prize focuses on the sea. The Sunhok Peace Prize Committee has focused on the problem of climate change and food security with the founder's vision of peace in mind. The committee has chosen as the co-awardees of the first Sunhok Peace Prize President Anote Tong of Kiribati, who has worked steadfastly to address the crisis posed by climate change and to make the world better for future generations, and Dr. Modadugu Gupta of India, who has developed an innovative technology for fish farming that will help solve the food crisis in the future. Both laureates have devoted their lives to peace. President Anote Tong of Kiribati, a visionary addressing a challenge to humankind's peaceful coexistence. Dr. Modadugu Gupta of India, who works in the front line of the battle against future food crises. The men and women who have worked to overcome the difficulties faced by humanity and who have brought the flowers of hope into bloom are the heroes of the Sunhok Peace Prize. Which flowers of hope are blossoming in your heart right now? The Sunhok Peace Prize will become the bouquet of hope. We will create a better future, a new civilization of peace.
We
have watched a video of how Sunhok Peace Prize came together just a moment ago.
네, 이어서 홍일식 위원장의 환영사가 있겠습니다. 홍일식 위원장께서는 한국을 대표하는 인문학자로서 고려대 총장을 역임하셨습니다. 오늘 시상식이 있기까지 선학 평화상 위원회를 이끌어 오셨습니다.
Next, Sunhok Peace Prize Committee Chairman Dr. Il-sik Hong will give his welcoming address. As Korea's foremost scholar in humanities, he has served as president of Korea University. Please give him a big round of applause.
존경하는 내외 귀빈 여러분. 오늘 제1회 선학 평화상 시상식에 이처럼 성황을 이루어 주신 데 대해서 열렬한 환영의 말씀과 더불어 진심으로 감사를 드립니다. 특별히 세계 각국에서 오신 여러 정상 및 귀빈 여러분, 그리고 한국을 대표해서 참석해 주신 정의화 국회의장님께 깊은 감사를 드립니다. 과야흐로 평화에 대한 온 인류의 염원이 더욱 절실해져 가고 있는 이때에 대한민국 서울에서 제1회 선악평화상을 시상하게 된 것을 진정 뜻깊게 생각합니다. 특히 올해는 유엔이 창립된 지 70주년이자 대한민국 광복 또한 70주년이 되는 해로서 세계사적 흐름에서도 오늘 이 자리가 더욱 값지다고 하지 않을 수 없습니다. 무엇보다도 먼저 저는 미래의 평화를 위한 헌신적인 노력과 업적으로 오늘 제1회 선악평화상을 수상하시게 된 아노테 통 키리바시 공화국 대통령과 모다두고 BJ 굽타 박사님께 깊은 존경과 함께 뜨거운 축하의 뜻을 전합니다. 이미 아시고 계실 줄 믿습니다만은 선학평화상은 고 문선명 총재님의 사상과 업적을 기리고 그 유지를 선양하기 위해 영부인이신 한학자 여사님의 제안으로 제정되었습니다. 문선명 총재님은 일찍부터 모든 인류는 한 가족이라는 공생, 공영, 공의의 신념으로 범 인류 공동체 건설에 평생을 바쳐오신 분입니다. 이 평화의 비전은 인류는 연속적으로 세대에서 세대로 이어지는 한 가족이라는 매우 기본적인 전제에서 비롯되었습니다. 따라서 평화의 개념을 현재와 과거에 가둬두지 않고 미래로까지 확장시켜 새로운 평화의 지평을 열어가고자 하는 것입니다. 이것은 오늘의 우리가 왜 미래 세대의 평화를 준비해야 하는지 그 도덕적 책임 의식을 일깨우기 위한 것이기도 합니다. 지난 세기까지 평화의 핵심 이슈는 전쟁과 폭력의 극복이었습니다. 그동안 인류는 전쟁의 잿더미 속에서도 국제연맹과 국제연합을 차례로 탄생시켜 왔으며 오늘날 유엔은 세계대전을 방지하기 위해 그 소임을 다하고 있습니다. 하지만 21세기에 들어와서는 이 전쟁보다 더 무서운 재앙이 우리 인류를 위협하고 있습니다. 바로 자연의 재해와 각종 질병, 그 중에서도 특히 기후변화와 에너지 고갈 등에서 오는 전 지구적인 환경의 재앙입니다. 현 세대가 성장과 발전을 추구하며 무한 경쟁으로만 치닫는 동안 인류 공동체의 영원한 삶의 안식처인 이 지구는 심각하게 오염 파괴되었으며 이제 그 피해를 미래 세대가 고스란히 떠안아야 할 절박한 상황에 이르렀습니다. 이 절박한 위기 앞에서 인류를 한 가족으로 포용하려는 선악평화상의 웅대한 비전은 세계 평화의 새로운 지평을 제시하고 있는 것입니다. 평화는 곧 새로운 문명입니다. 인류가 20세기까지 쌓아올린 문명의 한계와 적폐를 넘어서 평화로운 미래, 진정으로 행복한 삶을 영위하기 위해서는 새 시대가 요구하는 새로운 문화를 창출해야만 합니다. 오늘의 세대는 탐욕과 이기심을 버리고 인종과 국경과 사상과 종교를 초월해서 범인류애에 기본한 평화 문명을 모색해야 할 역사적 소명을 부여받고 있습니다. 선악평화상은 이 새로운 세기를 향한 새로운 평화를 평화의 큰 밑그림을 그려가고자 합니다. 인류는 한 가족, 미래 세대를 위한 평화상이라는 기치 아래 인류의 모든 갈등을 해소하고 새로운 평화 문명을 선도하고자 합니다. 우리는 지구 어디에서나 도덕적 정당성과 논리적 합리성 위에서 새로운 시대가 요구하는 평화의 가치를 실천해 나가는 용기 있는 의인들을 계속 발굴하여 고무 격려해 나갈 것입니다. 중대한 역사적 소명을 부여받은 이 자리에서 오늘 선악평화상이 뿌린 이 평화의 씨앗은 앞으로 종교와 인종과 국가와 문화를 뛰어넘어 미래의 새로운 평화 문명으로 힘차게 뻗어나갈 것입니다. 이 새로운 앞길에 여러분의 적극적이고도 지속적인 그리고 애정어린 관심과 격려를 부탁해 마지않습니다. 감사합니다.
고맙습니다. 선악평화상 위원회 홍일식 위원장께서 환영의 말씀을 해주셨습니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give a big round of applause once again to Dr. Il-sik Hong.
감사합니다. 이어서 대한민국 입법부의 수장이신 정의화 국회의장께서 축하의 말씀을 해 주시겠습니다.
Now, Honorable Eui-hwa Chung, the Korean National Assembly Speaker, will give his congratulatory address. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a well round of applause to Mr. Eui-hwa Chung.
여러분 박수로 맞아주십시오.
제1회 선학평화상 시상식 개최를 진심으로 축하를 드립니다. 첫 번째 선학평화상 수상에 영예를 안으신 키리바시 공화국의 아노테 통 대통령님 그리고 인도의 모다두구 굽타 박사님께 존경의 인사를 드립니다. 오늘 이 자리는 인간에 대한 무한한 사랑을 실천하며 아름다운 공존의 세상을 만들어 오신 우리 시대의 영웅들을 격려하기 위해 마련되었습니다. 이 뜻깊은 행사에 초대해 주신 홍일식 위원장님을 비롯한 선악평화상 관계자 여러분들에게 감사의 말씀을 올립니다. 올해로 제2차 세계대전이 끝난 지 70년이 되었습니다. 그 참혹했던 공멸의 위기는 극복해내었지만 우리 인류는 전후에 다짐했던 희망의 역사를 아직도 써내려가지 못하고 있습니다. 국가 간, 지역 간, 인종 간, 그리고 종교 간 갈등은 여전하고 극단주의적 테러와 대량 살상무기 확산과 같은 새로운 위협이 부상하고 있습니다. 여기에 경제 위기와 기후 변화 등 또 다른 형태의 글로벌 도전들이 동시다발적으로 나타나고 있습니다. 이제 우리 인류는 현재의 위기를 바르게 진단하고 살기 좋은 지구를 만들어갈 새로운 대안을 마련해야 합니다. 저는 살기 좋은 지구를 만드는 해답을 문명의 힘에서 찾고 있습니다. 경제적으로 부를 쌓아서 무기를 개발하고 또 타국의 희생을 바탕으로 패권 국가가 되기 위해 노력하던 낡은 시대는 이미 끝났습니다. 21세기는 문명의 시대가 되어야 합니다. 그것은 각국이 인문과 문화의 꽃을 피워 상호 협력하는 시대를 뜻합니다. 각국이 경제적으로 경제를 부흥하려는 이유도 각국의 국민들은 물론이고 또 자연과 인간이 다 함께 잘 살기 위해서라야 합니다. 그래야 지구촌이 조화롭고 지속적인 발전을 이루어갈 수가 있는 것입니다. 그런 의미에서 인간과 자연에 대한 사랑, 공동체의 연대와 소통에 기반한 세상을 지향하는 선악 평화상의 비전은 우리에게 시사하는 바가 큽니다. 바다를 테마로 한 1회 선악 평화상의 수상자들은 그러한 미래 비전을 온몸으로 실천해 오신 분들입니다. 아노테통 대통령께서는 지구 온난화에 따른 해수면 상승에 직접적인 피해를 입으면서도 키리바시 국민들과 함께 해양 생태계 보호에 앞장서는 놀라운 인류애를 실천하고 계십니다. 그야말로 기후 위기에 맞서서 미래 세대를 지키는 인류의 수호자가 아닐 수가 없습니다. 모다두구 굽타 박사님 역시 동남아시아와 아프리카의 빈곤층을 위해서 물고기 양식 기술을 개발하고 보급하는 데 평생을 바쳤습니다. 가난과 굶주림이 없는 세계를 만들겠다는 굽타 박사님의 꿈과 노력은 이미 기적을 만들어내고 있습니다. 우리 인류에게는 나눔과 배려, 포용과 같은 아름답고 정의로운 공동의 가치가 있습니다. 오늘 두 분 수상자들의 삶을 통해서 우리는 우리 스스로 본연의 가치를 회복할 수 있다는 희망을 발견합니다. 그 희망을 쫓아 머지않아 모든 인류가 참다운 공생 공정의 길로 나아가게 될 것이라고 저는 확신하고 있습니다. 수상자들께 다시 한번 축하드리면서 이 상을 제정해 주신 분들 그리고 오늘 함께해 주신 모든 분의 가정에 건강과 축복이 깃들기를 기원합니다. 여러분 대단히 감사합니다.
감사합니다. 대한민국 입법부 수장이신 정의화 국회의장께서 축하의 말씀을 해주셨습니다.
Thank you once again, Honorable 의화 정, for making the time to attend our ceremony.
네, 이어서 유스프 칼라 인도네시아 부통령께서 축하의 말씀을 해주시겠습니다.
Continuing on, His Excellency Yusuf Kala, Vice President of Indonesia, will give his congratulatory address. Ladies and gentlemen, please give him a big round of applause.
오늘 이 자리를 위해서 먼 걸음을 해주셨습니다. 여러분 다시 한번 따뜻한 환영의 박수로 맞아주십시오.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Chairman, Dr. Gupta, Dr. Tong, Mr. Speaker. First of all, thank you very much for this invitation to talk and make inaugurals of the Suntak Peace Prize. Peace for us, it is needed. Everybody need peace. All the religions starting talk with peace. In Islam, they say, Assalamu alaikum, pray for peace of you. Christians say, Shalom, same peace of you. But what peace can be achieved? For us, peace is mean harmony. Harmony with peoples, harmony within state, harmony for everybody. The same as what today, harmony with natures, harmony with the earth. It is easy to say about harmony, but how we needed harmony of this situation. Harmony with natures, important thing because without harmony, the natures will be terror each others. Climate change is the others now on. This is one thing that everybody will be make a solutions about harmony with natures. Conflict, terrorism, is mean we need harmony with others. Harmony within state, harmony between state. Indonesia is my country, have 70 years of independence, nearly same with Korea. Within 70 years, we have around 15 times a big conflict within the country. 10 or 15 is because inequality. Equality in politics, equality in economy and social. No harmony in between. Conflicts because inequality. Equality between regions. This is making conflict in the countries. Now, in the world, there are so many regions, no peace. It's meaning the people's suffering in his life and every day. We see how many people, refugee, in many regions of the world, Asia, Middle East, Africa, and so on. Why that happen? Of course, because inequality, no harmony, and with others. Harmony and conflict can be more worse if they are including ideologies and religions. Why ideology and religions is not easier in the Africa conflict? Because you cannot stop ideology religion by weapon, by gun. Should be with under the ideologies, good ideologies and religions. This has happened everywhere. If you are learning in conflict and terrorism between countries, because the people needed one thing they can be better life. Nothing much better before. Today is everybody talking about ISIS before Al-Qaeda. What is happened? Because the countries destroy from for outside, and the country not enough government fail to protect the peoples, to protect everybody in the countries. And the peoples the other people coming to protect and giving ideologies, extreme ideologies, radical ideology to the countries. How's the solution? What happened? This is why destroy each country, destroy each other. There are some reasons why. Economic problems, political problems, and natural resources. It's one thing that we should make a better life in the world. Because without harmony, without every can easy, one country easily to destroy each country, and then will be coming radicalisms. And radicalism making the terrorism, terrorism making the peace, making a war. War is the end of the peace. The same as peace, the end of the war. But whatever peace, better than any war. One thing that we should work in together and making a joint hand by hand, everybody. In any countries that not stability, there are war. All people suffering, especially women, children. That's why we come here to putting our mind together, to stopping any effort to making with not harmony in our life, destroy each other, and making life not easier. In this happen, in these days, of course, we are congratulated to Sun Hak Peace Prize, and especially Dr. Gupta and Dr. Tong for his performance to make things more productive and harmony, the man, the people, with the natures. Because without harmony, productivity in everybody, and then the poor will be coming, and poor life making disharmony, and disharmony can make in conflict each other. That's why, again, thank you very much for this occasion. Hope that peace, harmony will be ours or target objective of each other. Thank you very much again. Thank you.
감사합니다. 유스프 칼라 인도네시아 부통령께서 오늘 이 자리를 축하하는 축하의 말씀을 해 주셨습니다.
Thank you, His Excellency Yusuf Kala, for making the congratulatory address.
이제 시상의 순서입니다. 먼저 키리바시의 아노테통 대통령의 업적을 영상을 통해서 만나보시겠습니다.
First, let's take a look at the achievements of the laureate, His Excellency Anote-tong, President of Kiribati, through a video presentation.
Concerns in the international community have been heightening for Kiribati, a small island nation in the South Pacific whose land is, on average, just 2 meters above sea level. Thanks to one man, the international community is coming together to ensure humanity's cooperation in solving the climate change issue. Kiribati is an island nation famous for its dazzling emerald waters and beautiful coral reefs. A small island nation with a population of only 100,000, its people may have a simple lifestyle, but they have lived happily until now. But the country is in danger of being lost to rising sea levels due to climate change, which is proving a disaster for this nation. Children live with the fear that their country may vanish from the face of the earth within the next 30 years. The ocean is gradually swallowing everything. Its people are ill at ease as drinking water and trees dry up and the incidence of disease increases. But they are not accepting their fate without putting up a fight. Together with his nation's people, President Anote-tong has built dikes and planted mangroves that can grow underwater in an attempt to confront the waves flooding his nation. However, the load has been too great for a small country to bear alone. For the children of Kiribati, who are on the verge of losing their country, the future looks bleak. The people are beginning to live in fear for their lives.
I'm afraid of my own country because see the Russia soon it will cover my country. I really love my country and I love all the people in my country. And so could you please help my country?
President Dong began to urgently appeal to the international community that climate change is not a thing of the future, but an immediate threat. He appealed to the world that the rights of people whose homes are under threat of submergence must come before the rights of polar bears. He stressed that in the not-so-distant future, this threat will be a problem for the entire world.
It will not do simply to say and acknowledge that climate change is an existential challenge. It is about our response to it as a global community of moral human beings.
President Tong is pioneering a path to secure a beautiful coexistence between humanity and the Earth, vowing not to make the same mistakes that humankind has made up to this point. Despite Kiribati's harsh reality, he proceeded to lead the world's largest marine protection and management initiative. In 2010, he brought delegates from the world's major carbon-emitting nations to Kiribati and held the Tarawa Climate Change Conference. This led to the opportunity for developed countries to give support to vulnerable nations at the UNFCCC Cancun Conference. President Tong aggressively sought to protect the rights of climate refugees through the Migration with Dignity education program, so that his people will be respected in other countries as they migrate there away from the crisis. To make sure his citizens retain their rights as human beings, even after they have lost their homeland, he has implemented vocational training programs and purchased land abroad. At first, no one listened to the appeals from President Tong, who wants to save humanity and the Earth from the climate crisis. However, through his dedication, the international community gradually began to recognize his dedication, and the whole world began to pay attention to climate change. At last, the world's major economies are coming together. The UN has put climate change at the top of its agenda and is planning countermeasures. President Tong has invested himself to accomplish what no other president in the world has been able to achieve. He is bringing hope for the future of the planet. Global warming needs to be acted upon now, not tomorrow, because all our futures are at stake here. A solution to the climate crisis must be put forth right now. Future peace is not set in stone, but is to be created by the people of today.
업적을 화면을 통해서 소개를 해드렸습니다. 이제 메달과 상패를 수여하는 순서입니다. 수여에는 설립자이신 한학자 총재와 홍일식 위원장께서 수고해 주시겠습니다.
Now a medal and plaque will be awarded. The medal and plaque will be given by founder Dr. 학자 한문 and committee chairman Dr. 일식 홍.
지금 수여될 메달은 순금 187.5g으로 한국 조폐공사에서 특별히 제작했고요. 상패는 한국의 자계 명인이 정성들여 제작했습니다.
The medal is made of 17.5 grams of pure gold and specially made by the Korea Minting and Security Printing Corporation. And the plaque was made by Korean traditional master artisan of mother of pearl.
메달과 상패를 수여하고 있습니다. 여러분 다시 한번 큰 박수로 축하해 주십시오. 축하드립니다. 아노테통 대통령께서 선악 평화상을 수상하고 계십니다. 자, 이제 전달해 주십시오.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give Dr. Anotetong once again a big round of applause.
Thank you. 감사합니다. 아노테통 대통령께서 선악 평화상의 주인공이 되셨습니다. 이제 메달과 상패를 전달받으셨고요. 이 자리를 축하하고 기념하는 기념 촬영이 잠시 이어지겠습니다.
We will take a short moment to have a photo time. The laureate of the Sonak Peace Prize.
네. 이제 아노테통 대통령의 수상 연설이 있겠습니다.
Now, President Tong has gone further than anybody in raising awareness about the effects of climate change to the global community and is devoted to the beautiful coexistence of humanity and the earth. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now hear President Tong making his acceptance speech.
여러분, 다시 한번 박수로 청해 듣겠습니다.
Dr. Ha, Jahan Moon, our gracious host, Dr. Il-sik Hong, the Speaker of the National Assembly of the Republic of Korea, together with distinguished excellencies, distinguished delegates who are present here this morning, President and members of the Universal Peace Federation, and of course, distinguished members of the Sonak Peace Prize Committee. My colleague and co-recipient of the award, Dr. Modaduku Gupta, and of course, my wife, who is here to join me on this occasion, friends, ladies, and gentlemen. As is customary in my tradition, allow me to share with you our Kiribati traditional blessings, Kamnabene Nimaur, meaning, may you all be blessed. I wish to begin by taking a moment to pay very special tribute to the late Reverend Sun Myung Moon and to Dr. Hak Cha Han Moon for their lifelong vision and work, which is underpinned by the ultimate goal of achieving global peace for all. Indeed, had the global community embraced these visions of promoting reconciliation, coexistence, and cooperation, the world would certainly be a much better place and a more peaceful place today. I also wish to congratulate Dr. Hak Chan Hang Moon, together with the chairman and members of the committee, for this inaugural Sonak Peace Prize Award Ceremony, an initiative of immense international significance. In order to pursue, to continue Reverend Moon's legacy of one family under God. For my part, I am truly honored to be a co-recipient of this inaugural award of the Sonak Peace Prize for 2015. For the last 12 years have been for me a lot of challenges, starting from when my people elected me into office in 2003 to guide them towards a safe, secure, and prosperous future. Upon accepting that honor, I also accepted the responsibility that came with it, one of which is to ensure that their voice, their issues would be heard, especially within the international arena. In receiving this most prestigious award, it is indeed my most fervent hope that it will lend greater force to the urgency of the message which I have over the years been trying to communicate to the global community about the existential threat both posed by climate change to the future survival of future generations of my people and those in similar situations. Climate change affects all of us in varying degrees of severity. But for my people and all of those who live on low-lying atoll islands, we are at the front line of this global calamity, with the very real possibility that our islands, our livelihoods, our homes, our identity as a people and as a culture may indeed cease to exist well within the century. As leaders, we all have a duty to protect and safeguard those people for whom we are responsible. As parents and as grandparents, it is only natural and instinctive that we would do so with our life if necessary. For those who rely on us for their security, and I do believe it is the moral obligation of all humanity to ensure that all future generations be guaranteed a safe and a secure future. Ladies and gentlemen, it is against this background that I honor and acknowledge the most notable contribution of my fellow awardee, Dr. Gupta, whose lifelong work will forever remain an inherent feature of the ongoing work on global food security. It is an honor to be considered alongside a worthy fellow awardee such as Dr. Gupta. Let me also take this opportunity to acknowledge the one person who has supported and tolerated me throughout the years, especially in those dark moments of frustration and despair when I felt a deep sense of futility that no one was listening to me. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to acknowledge my wife, Nenma. This award is as much for her as for all our dozen or so grandchildren, as well as those grandchildren whose voice we have tried to represent over the years. For their sake, let us do what is right for them. In closing, let me share with you our very traditional blessings of Te Māori, Te Rā I Te Tapamua, meaning health, peace, and prosperity be upon us all. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. 다시 한번 말씀드리겠습니다. 영광의 주인공 아노테통 대통령의 소감을 청해 들었습니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, we just heard the acceptance speech made by President Anote-tong.
이어서 공동 수상자인 인도의 모다두구 굽타 박사를 만날 시간입니다. 먼저 그 업적을 영상을 통해서 소개해드리겠습니다.
Next, the Sonak Peace Prize will be awarded to the dual laureate, Dr. Modadugu Vijay Gupta of India. First, let's take a look at the video presentation on his achievements.
One man planted seeds of hope for the poorest of the poor around the world, that they may live a better life. One man carved out a path and paved the way for the Blue Revolution. Why don't you work if you're so poor? I want to work and change my destiny, but there's no place to go. There is no hope for me. In order to break the vicious cycle of poverty passed down through generations, there was a need for measures that went further than simply providing food. Self-reliance and hope were needed. There was a boy who watched fishermen who were poor but lived happily catching fish, and began to dream of becoming a fisheries scientist. He became a biologist to pursue his dream of creating a world without poverty. And from the 1960s, he plunged into aquaculture research. This led him to Bangladesh, where over 80% of the population lived in extreme poverty.
When I started the aquaculture research in 1970, aquaculture was mostly done in the research laboratories. I wanted to make a difference, that whatever the technology we want to develop in the field, so that whatever technology is developed, that is proven that it's suitable for that farming community.
Dr. Gupta left his laboratory and, living the same lifestyle as the farmers, learning to communicate in the local language, he started to identify areas where aquaculture might be possible. Anywhere there was water became the site of a prominent fish farm. Dr. Gupta identified fish species suited for the local conditions, developed aquaculture technologies, and passionately gathered people together and taught them aquaculture. In those days, many women in Southeast Asia lived without the protection of human rights. It turned out that women had a knack for farming fish, and the lives of women who learned how to raise fish began to change. Currently, 60% of Bangladeshi aquaculture practitioners are women.
And due to Dr. Gupta, you know, this tremendous change in Bangladesh now in the fish culture, actually. I think this is the great achievement for the country in fish culture, you know, from probably 300 to 400 times more now we culture in the fish in Bangladesh. When he started, by 20 years, a lot of changes.
People started referring to this explosive increase in fish production as humanity's blue revolution. Food shortages due to climate change. Reduced agricultural yield by 2050. The worst ever food riots. The majority of seafood we consume in the future is expected to be raised by fish farming. The Blue Revolution, designed by Dr. Gupta, has therefore become a model solution to humanity's future food crisis. In 2005, Dr. Gupta was awarded the World Food Prize, known as the Nobel Prize for Food and Agriculture, in recognition of his leading role as the architect of the Blue Revolution. Dr. Gupta's challenge has gone beyond Southeast Asia and extended into the Pacific region and Africa. Dr. Gupta's extraordinary ambition of planting seeds of hope in the poorest areas has grown into a miracle of independence for people and is still spreading. Traveling the Indian coastal shores, the boy who watched as poor fishermen caught fish for a living has become a world-class fisheries scientist and cultivated a miracle of self-sufficiency for the world's poor.
빛나는 업적을 영상을 통해 만나보셨습니다. 이제 시상을 하겠습니다. 한학자 종재와 홍일식 위원장께서는 시상을 위해서 다시 한번 무대 중앙에 자리해 주십시오.
A medal and plaque will be awarded by the founder, Dr. 학자 한문, and the committee chairman, Dr. 일식 홍.
이제 모다두구 굽타 박사께 시상을 하도록 하겠습니다.
Now the awarding ceremony begins.
다시 한번 축하의 박수를 부탁드리겠습니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, please congratulate the winner of the Sonak Peace Prize, Dr. Moradugu Gupta, with a big round of applause.
한국조폐공사에서 특별히 제작한 순금 187.5g의 메달, 그리고 한국의 자개 명인이 정성 들여 제작한 상패가 주어지고 있습니다. 다시 한번 축하의 말씀드리겠습니다. 그동안의 빛나는 업적으로 오늘 선악평화상의 또 한 분의 주인공이 되셨습니다. 설립자이신 한학자 총재와 홍일식 위원장께서 시상을 해주셨고요. 이제 오늘 이 자리를 기념하는 기념 촬영이 잠시 이어지겠습니다. 감사합니다. 자, 이제 시상에 이어서 모다두구 굽타 박사의 소감을 청해 듣겠습니다. 수상 연설이 이어지겠습니다.
And next up, Dr. Moradugu Gupta will give his acceptance speech. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, please give him a big round of applause.
다시 한번 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Madam Dr. Hakja Han Moon, founder of the Sonak Peace Prize, Dr. Il-Shik Hong, chair of the Sonak Peace Prize Committee, Excellencies, honorable delegates, media representatives, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning. I feel it an honor and privilege to be selected for the first Sonak Peace Prize. I am glad that the Sonak Peace Prize Committee recognizes the importance of food security, environmental integrity, and overall socio-economic development as essential prerequisites for a peaceful society. This becomes much more important in the present-day context of increasing global population, leading to more demand for food from declining natural resources and the looming impact of global warming threatening the fragile ecosystem and lives and livelihoods of large number of people if appropriate actions are not taken in time. I thank Madam Dr. Hakja Han Moon for her vision in establishing this award and reminding the global community the need to act fast for a food secure and peaceful world. I owe gratitude to a great number of people, the farming community, the non-governmental organizations, scientists, planners, administrators, and the donor community in different countries where I work, without whose assistance and cooperation it would not have been possible for me to do what I have done. I would be failing in my responsibility as a husband and father if I do not acknowledge the sacrifices of my wife and children I have made over the years to enable me to work, continue my work while living and working in remote areas of least developed and war-torn countries in spite of threats to our lives. The world has made tremendous progress technologically in the last few decades. Whether we call it an industrial revolution, information technology, rocket technology, space science, or agriculture. However, we failed to provide sufficient food to people in this world, because of which we see so much hunger and poverty around the world, which is leading to civil strifes and food riots. One in three people globally suffer from hidden hunger or micronutrient deficiencies, especially the women and children. We have been talking of eliminating hunger and poverty for quite some time, but we have a long way to go to reach our goal. In spite of increased production of food, hunger has remained as a persistent problem for too many world's poor. Rampant hunger and poverty is leading to deterioration in democratic institutions and increased incidence of demonstrations, riots, and civil conflicts. Personally, I have witnessed what hunger means while working in war-ravaged countries. Even in middle-income countries, despite being more affluent, are still home to majority of the world's hungry people. We cannot expect peace and tranquility in a world that continues to suffer from hunger and poverty. If appropriate action is not taken, prolonged hunger and undernutrition can have developmental and economic damage for a number of years to come. For eliminating hunger and malnutrition, we need a new approach of inclusive and sustainable growth. I repeat, the growth has to be very inclusive and sustainable. That provides livelihoods to all and preserves the environment for our future generations, leading to a peaceful world. Over 500 million small farmers manage most of the world's agriculture land, including fish farming, and produce most of the world's food. We cannot imagine a situation without them. We need to ensure survival of these farms, not just for their livelihood and survival, but also for global food security and alleviation of poverty, undernutrition, and malnutrition. I strongly believe that small farms and farmers in developing countries are the backbone of food security, and hence my work over the years has been in this direction, developing low-input, low-cost technologies that could be adopted and sustained by small-scale farmers, especially women, leading to their empowerment. This award gives me the added energy to pursue my lifetime goals of contributing for a peaceful society through alleviation of hunger and poverty. I pay homage to Reverend Dr. Sun Yung Moon for the ideals he stood for and his vision of one global peaceful family. Let us all work together to bring his ideals to reality. Thank you all.
Thank you. 네. 감사합니다. 오다두구 쿱타 박사의 수상 연설을 함께 하셨습니다.
We just heard the acceptance speech made by Dr. Motadugu Gupta from India.
네, 이어서 한학자 총재와 홍일식 위원장 그리고 영광의 두 분 수상자께서 함께 기념 촬영을 하시겠습니다.
Now we will take a short moment to take a photo time with Dr. 학자 한문, Committee Chairman Dr. 일식 홍, and His Excellency Dr. Motadugu Gupta all together.
네. 선학평화상의 영광스러운 두 분의 주인공과 이 자리를 준비해 주신 한학자 총재 그리고 홍일식 위원장께서 함께 오늘 이 자리를 기념하는 기념 촬영을 하고 계십니다. 영예 메달과 상패를 들고 이 자리의 의미를 더욱 빛내고 계신 영예 수상자십니다.
Now the two laureates and Dr. 일식 홍 and Ms. 학자 한문.
네, 감사합니다. 자, 이제 기념 촬영에 이어서 아래에 준비되어 있는 자리로 이동해 주시길 부탁드리겠습니다.
Now, please make your way to your seats down below.
네, 이제 자리로 이동하셔서 오늘 이 순간을 위해 준비된 축하 무대를 여기 계신 분들과 함께 즐기시는 시간입니다. 자, 먼저 노래하는 작은 천사, 한국의 민간 외교 사절단이라 불리는 리틀 엔젤스가 여러분께 멋진 공연을 준비하고 있습니다. 그리고 이어서 특별한 분이 오늘 무대에 함께 하겠습니다. 신이 내린 목소리, 한국이 낳은 세계적인 소프라노 조수미 씨가 여러분께 멋진 무대를 보여드리겠습니다.
To commemorate this special occasion, we have wonderful congratulatory song performances prepared for you. First, the little diplomats of Korea, the little angels, will begin preparing on the stage. And next up, a very special figure has prepared a performance for this special occasion. The God-given voice, the Korean-born world-class vocalist, soprano Sumi Jo, is here to serenade us with her incredible voice.
네, 제1회 선악평화상을 축하하기 위해 멋지게 준비한 무대입니다. 여러분, 함께 즐겨주시면 감사하겠습니다. Little Angels와 조수미 씨의 무대입니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Little Angels Art School with a big round of applause.
다시 한번 큰 박수로 맞아주십시오.
그 미도
Thank you.
Shall we?
네, 여러분 아름다운 무대를 만들어준 조수미 씨, 리틀 엔젤스 예술단 그리고 과천 시립 교향악단 여러분이었습니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give one more big round of applause to soprano Sumi Jo, the Little Angels, and the 과천 Symphony Orchestra.
네, 고맙습니다. 자, 멋진 축하 무대를 끝으로 제1회 선악평화상 시상식을 모두 마치겠습니다. 먼저 한학자 총재와 홍일식 위원장을 비롯한 각국 정상들께서 먼저 퇴장하시겠습니다.
We'll now conclude the inaugural 2015 Sona Peace Prize Ceremony. Dr. Hakja Han Moon, Committee Chairman Dr. Il-shik Hong, and all the international VIPs will exit. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a big round of applause to all the VIPs.
네, 여러분 다시 한번 박수 부탁드리겠습니다. 오늘 자리를 빛내주신 모든 분들께 깊은 감사의 말씀드립니다.
Once again, we extend our sincere gratitude to all the VIPs and attendees who are here with us today.
잠시 안내 말씀드리겠습니다. 오늘 참석해 주신 분들을 위해 주최 측에서 작은 기념품을 준비했습니다. 순은으로 만든 시상 메달이 되겠습니다. 그리고 로비에는 여러분들을 위한 뷔페가 준비되어 있습니다.
Our final announcement, we have prepared souvenirs for you to take home. These are award ceremony medal replicas made out of pure silver. And please help yourself to the buffet prepared for you outside the lobby.
네, 많은 분들께서 함께 즐겨주시길 부탁드리겠습니다. 자, 다시 한번 선악평화상 시상식을 빛내주신 분들께 깊은 감사의 말씀드리면서 공식 순서는 여기서 모두 마치겠습니다.
Distinguished guests, thank you very much again for attending the inaugural 2015 선악 Peace. Peace Prize Ceremony.
네, 여러분 고맙습니다.
So far, it was broadcaster Young Yin Shin and Arirang TV announcer Sammy Jung. Thank you very much.